Hey everyone, my name's Kyle. Thanks for stopping by to check out my video here on Arena Hacks. I like just sharing all kinds of decks that I build. I build a lot of budget decks and all kinds of fun stuff. I do like helping people with tips and tricks for growing their digital collection on MTG Arena. So if you're into any of that stuff, please hit the subscribe button down in the bottom corner of your screen. Today I'm doing something a little different. I'm doing one of my videos where I'm not in the gameplay, but I'm not in the video at all, but I'm actually going to be doing this introduction just because it's a little different than what I normally do. It was from the midweek Artisan event, and I wasn't planning on making a video of it at all, but I was playing it and I built these decks for it, and I turned on my screen recorder while I was playing, and the games turned out really awesome, right? I built two decks that worked out really well, so I thought I'd share the video with you guys. But yeah, I did want to do, it was just a little, there's two different decks and it was a little more complicated. So I'm like, I don't want to just show the decks and then go into it. So I wanted to do this more personal introduction to the video. Also do a little bit in the conclusion as well. But as you see here, Treasure Hunt, this is one of the decks. This is the second deck I played. I'll get to the first deck I played second, which will lead right into the gameplay. But here we go, Treasure Hunt. It looks pretty much the same as what you may have seen in another video. I'll put the link up there if you want to go check out the video where I made my own version of Treasure Hunt from the version they built, the pre-constructed. And the main difference here is I took out all the rares and I put in a bunch of uncommon dragons to be our big game ender. I did put in an extra Grim Bounty in place of a rare removal. And then, yeah, more Jaded Cell Swords. Again, they're just, these are dragons. They're more pack-a-punch. And they do have a treasure synergy in them as well, so that's about the only difference, is just these guys. The red dragon gives that extra damage, so it's very powerful. This guy's removal, he's very clunky on mana cost, which is why I only have one copy in here, but this guy replaced basically the gelatinous cube because it was a creature that had removal attached to it, and this is more or less the same thing. It's also kind of a game ender finisher, especially when we cast black dragon with treasures and we have Kalain on the battlefield, because then our dragon is just not a 4/4 anymore. These dragons are big and powerful. So that's our main win con here. That's about the only differences to the deck. It's pretty much just the same. And let's go take a look at the other gain, which is Selesnya life gain deck, the Lifeline deck. Okay, so here's the Selesnya life gain deck that I have, the Lifeline, and again, you see all the rares were taken out. I increased the number of attended healers. I think I increased the number of Impassioned Orators and Hallowed Priests, I think, as well. These were all, I think this was three of, and I think this was two or three of, and I just increased all those numbers. The attended healer I thought was a good swap for, what was that angel? The big one that creates 4/4 angel tokens when you gain so much life, right? And then this, I put an additional orator in place of the Valkyrie, the Righteous Valkyrie, the one that gains you life. And then Hallowed Priest in place of, not even sure. Blizzard Brawl, I think I did in place of Inscription of Abundance. And then Charge Through and Rune of Might. This is actually something special, kind of why I saved this deck for a little bit later, is the trample here was a suggestion from Anders Jorth on one of my other videos. So the first game you guys are going to see here is dedicated to you, Anders, because, well, you'll see why in the game. Just watch the game and you'll see why. It was your suggestion to get some trample in here, and that first game will explain it all. So let's go check it out. Thank you. Okay, so there was. That was the Artisan event. That was my games. I had a pretty good run there. Do you guys think they should do a permanent Artisan event? I, for one, think they should. There should be one around all the time that we can play in. They can do these Artisan events where they give away those two rare cards every time. This midweek stuff is replacing the Friday night magic that they were doing. They're not doing the FNM anymore. They're doing this midweek magic now. But yeah, a full-time Artisan queue. What do you guys think about that? I would love to have that around. I would love to play around with more decks like this. I think it would be great for beginners who don't have all the rares and all the best mythics and stuff like that. It would give them more of a competitive advantage on a budget while still helping them improve. If you're brand new at Magic the Gathering, I think an Artisan queue would be a great place where you can go play and learn how to get better at the game. There will be more advanced players playing in the Artisan queue, and they'll still... you'll still lose to them a lot because they just know how to use those commons and uncommons much better. So you can learn from that though. So I think an Artisan queue would just be the greatest thing. What do you guys think of that? Please put it down in the comments. If enough of you comment, I might start looking into how we can maybe suggest and reach out to Wizards of the Coast and maybe make this a suggestion. And hopefully at some point in the future, maybe see if we can actually get them to include a full-time Artisan queue in Magic the Gathering Arena. I think that would be awesome. What do you guys think about the decks, the two decks that I showed today? I know they're kind of a repeat of what I've already done, but that's the easiest way when an Artisan event like this comes up. You take a deck that you already have that doesn't have a super amount of rares in it, which none of these decks did, and you just trim out the rares and put in uncommons that kind of you think closely match what the rares do. And that's how you get a solid, powerful Artisan deck. So, yeah, what do you guys think of the decks? What do you guys think of this video? What do you think of my idea for that permanent Artisan queue? I would really love to see that in Arena. And what do you think of the video? Hit the thumbs up if you like what you see. And like I said earlier, hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers.